Hello everybody and welcome back to another episode of my proposed future Japanese tank tech tree series. Now today we're looking at the tank destroyers slash assault guns that the Japanese used during World War II or developed during World War II. As you can see there's quite a few of them and I think Japan will do very well on this front of the tank tech tree. So without any further ado, let's get straight into the episode. Now first of all, this is not a Type 5 Horu. Just want to get that out of the way before anyone, you know, accuses me of misleading. This is actually a Hetzer, German Hetzer to be precise, but the Type 5 Horu, from what I understand, looked extremely similar to this. Had the same sort of mission, same sort of design, you know, low profile, tank destroyer, but it was had a few massive differences. First of all, it only had a 47mm gun. Now, we've looked at that before and all sorts of conflicting, you know, records on what the penetration is, but 55 to 60 at 100 meters, 40 to 65mm penetration at 500, or 30 to 50 at 1000. So, that's why I've put it at tier 1. Armor, I don't actually know what the armor is, but I assume, because this is based on the Type 95 chassis, that only had a maximum armor of about 12mm, so I'm going to assume it's not going to be too heavily armoured. Speed, the Type 95 again, which it's based on, was about 18 miles per hour off-road and 28 on-road, so probably similar speeds. Now, only one of these was actually built in, if I can find it, June 1945, according to my book by Zaloga. Now, there's no actual photographs of it, and I don't know what the documentation of it is like, so that's why I've put it underlined and bolded in the tech tree. Now you may also want to point out that it's a 1945 tank, it can't go in tier 1, that wouldn't make any sense. But if we go into the War Thunder game itself, so we're on War Thunder itself, we're on the German tech tree. If we go to the SDKFZ140/1 and we go to tank information, we can see that this was accepted into the Wehrmacht in 1944. This is a tier 1 tank at a battle rating of 1.3. So we can see there's already a precedent for, you know, late war tanks being in the early tiers. So now that we've seen it can go on the tech tree at tier 1, what battle rating should it get? I believe it should get a battle rating of about 2 or 1.7 for the simple reason that its competitors, the Stug A and the Sis 30, both have extremely superior penetration characteristics. You know, I don't want the Type 5 Horu to be too low in battle rating, but I think 1.72 is probably where it could go. I think that's the best place for it. Not too overpowered, and it's not in a position where it's going to just get, you know, slaughtered by enemy tanks. Now, the next tank destroyer we're looking at is the Type 1 Honi 1. Now, this was armed with a 75mm Type 90 gun. Now, the penetration of this is apparently, or from what I can understand, very similar to the Type 3, which was actually based on the Type 90. So again, between 80 to 90 at 100 metres penetration, 74 to 80 at 500, and probably about 67 at 1000. With special ammunition, it should be able to do 100mm at 500. So quite a powerful tank. Armour-wise, it's 25 to 51, although I think the 51 was only around the gun shield. The rest of it was mainly 25mm from what I understand. Unless I'm mistaken, speed would have been about 24 miles an hour and the Honi 1 would have carried 5 crew members. Now one thing to remember is this is not a fully enclosed turret on the tank. It's got limited traverse, it's not actually a turret, but I believe the rear and top are, or at least the rear, are exposed, which, you know, would be a bit of a problem for the crew members. Now where would I put this battle rating wise? I've put it tier 2, but it's because that's, you know, it's better than tier 1, but I think it'd be outclassed at tier 3. It would have to be lower battle rating than the Stug 3F, because that seems to outclass it in penetration, characteristics, armour, all that sort of stuff. Probably about the same place as the Su-76, which is 2.7, so about 3, 2.7, somewhere there. You know, it won't be too over-tiered or under-tiered at that point, and I think it would do very well there. Now after the Type 1 Honi 1, the Japanese created the Type 1 Honi 2, which is basically the same tank but with a 105mm howitzer on it instead of the 75mm field gun. Now I think it has pretty much the same stats as the Type 1 Honi 1. I think the gun shield might be slightly thinner, I think it's something like 40mm rather than 50. The gun, I couldn't actually find much penetration characteristics for it. The best I could find was 83mm at 100 meters, or 70 at 1,000, or 120mm with high explosive anti-tank. Now, this is only ever so slightly better than the Honey 1. I think 3mm better at 100 meters and 1,000 meters. The high explosive anti-tank is very good. You know, it's better. I think it's better than the Stug 3F's high explosive anti-tank. On account of the high explosive anti-tank, I've put the Type 1 Honey 2 at very low, or high tier 2, sorry, or very low tier 3. It could go as well. It should be able to deal with pretty much most American tanks at that tier. Battle rating wise, I'd put it about 3.7 with the Stug 3F. The Stug 3G's at 4.7, or about 3.7 to 4.3, somewhere around there, because it should be able to deal with pretty much every American tank around that battle rating with the high explosive anti-tank round. You know, it should be able to deal with any Shermans it comes across, and I think this will be a very good, capable tank destroyer. Now, after the Type 1 Honey 2, we come to the Type 3 Honey 3. The tank between the Type 2 Ho-I was a fire support tank, which we've already looked at in the medium tank episode of the Tech Tree series. Now, there are quite a few differences with the Type 3 Honey compared to the previous models. One, it has a fully enclosed superstructure, so the crew is completely protected from shrapnel, enemy bullets, that sort of thing. The gun, some sources say it's a 75mm Type 3 gun, some are saying it's a Type 90. I would have thought it would be a Type 3 gun, because apparently this was built with more of a tank destroyer role in mind, so I'm assuming it's going to be a Type 3 75mm gun. Armour, this is actually worse, 12 to 25mm. They've got a fully enclosed superstructure, but they got rid of that gun shield, which had something like 50 to 40mm of protection. Speed was about the same as the Type 1 Honey, so about 24 miles an hour, and again, there were 5 crew. Now, I have put this at Tier 3, but it's not that much of an improvement over the previous models. I believe it should only be about 0.3 or 0.6 higher than the Type 1 Honey 2, so if that gets put at 3.7, this should be 4. If the Type 1 Honey 2 gets put at 4.3, this should be 4.6 to 5, or 4.9, something like that. I think it would be a very good tank destroyer, but it's not a massive improvement over the previous models, if I'm honest. Now, the next few tanks, I'm not entirely sure what order to put in, because I haven't been able to find many penetration characteristics for them, so these are in the order I think they should be, but, you know, some of you may disagree. Gaijin would probably put them in a different order, possibly. But anyway, the next tank, or next tank destroyer assault gun, is the Type 4 Ho-Ro. Now, this has a 150mm howitzer on it, and armour isn't particularly good. 25mm on the gun shield, and it's all riveted, which is not good at all. The top speed was about 24 miles an hour. Now, I'm not sure of the penetration characteristics for the gun used on the Type 4, but it's a big gun, 150mm. The ISU-152 in-game, a similar calibre, does something like 75mm damage just on the with the high explosive. I don't know if this gets high explosive anti-tank. In the Philippines, I think there was only 2 sent to the Philippines, but I think they destroyed something like 7 there and damaged quite a few others, so there must be fairly good tanks or tank destroyers, assault guns, you know, penetration wise. Where would it go battle rating wise? It's going to be quite tricky, actually. I've put it at tier 3. I think it could probably go about the same as the SU-152, so a battle rating of 5. I don't think that'd be too over-tiered or under-tiered. I think, you know, that's pretty much the only place I can think of it to go, but it should be a nice little assault gun slash tank destroyer if added into the game. Now, the next tank destroyer slash assault gun, I don't actually know the name of. It's a Type 97 Chaihar, but it seems to have a, from what I understand, 120mm gun on it. Some sort of naval gun, from what I understand. I have no idea what the penetration characteristics would be on this thing, but it must be bloody big, if it was meant to be a naval gun. Now, presumably this has similar armour to the regular Type 97 Chaihar, so something like 8 to 28mm. Speed, I assume, is going to be roughly the same at 24 miles an hour, probably 4 crew again. Now, I don't know where to put this battle rating wise. I've put it tier 3, like with the Type 4 Ho-Ro, but I don't know if this is better than the Ho-Ro or worse. If it was a naval gun, I would have thought it'd be better, but, you know, I'm not really sure. So, probably five something, but you know, between five and six battle rating wise, something like that. I'm not really sure where to put it, but I think it would be a nice unique tank destroyer slash assault gun to have in the game. From what I understand, there was also a version with a long 120mm gun, but I couldn't find any information on that, so I haven't included it in the tech tree. Now, there wasn't too much information on this next tank destroyer slash assault gun, but there is a photograph of it, so I've decided to include it just in case. It's the Type 4 HOTO. Now, this was based on the Type 95 Hargo, so probably about the same armour, which I think was something like 12mm, and it was armed with a 120mm howitzer. Top speed would probably have been quite similar, so if I can find it, probably about 18 miles off-road, 28 on-road. Crew, I'm guessing, would have been about 4 to 5. Now, I don't know the penetration characteristics of the gun, so I don't know if this should go before the HORO or after it. It was developed about the same time, but again, a battle rating of between 5 and 6, possibly, maybe a little bit lower. I mean, like I said, I wasn't sure which order to put these few tanks in, but I think it would be another good addition for the Japanese tank tech tree. Now, the last tank on the list is the Type 5 NATO, which is, I think, the last Japanese tank destroyer to be put into production or developed. And it looks a bit like a truck at the front. I'm not sure why. Maybe they based it. I think they based it on something else, I assume. But it was armed with a Type 5 75mm gun. And like the Type 3 and other guns, this has contradictory penetration stats. 90 to 115 at 100 meters, 84 to 115 at 500, or 75 to 77 at 1000. So it should do quite well, but it depends which stats we believe. Armor was very thin, only something like 12mm, and it was reasonably fast, about 25 miles an hour. But interestingly, it's recorded as having 7 crew. I've heard something about 4 loaders being on this thing, which seems a bit overkill. You know, driver, gunner, commander, that's 3, plus 4 loaders, that would equal 7, but I don't know why you'd need 4 loaders for one gun. I think there was a machine gun on it, but I'm not sure who would have been using that. Maybe it's 3 loaders and a machine gunner, or something like that. Now, tier-wise, I've put this at tier 4, although it may struggle a little bit there. I think it should be very low tier 4. Battle rating-wise, it can deal with the Shermans, but once you get to the M26, it's going to struggle a little bit. So, I'm not really sure where to put it. Probably something like battle rating 6.7, maybe. I'm not really sure. It's kind of outclassed by most of its contemporary tank destroyers. It would have to be very low battle rating, no higher than 6.7 really. You know, so it's probably going to go up against more the lightly arm, well, less armored Shermans, I suppose, and maybe the M26s at most. Otherwise, it's just going to get slaughtered. Now, the next self-propelled gun or assault gun slash tank destroyer is the experimental Type 56 105mm self-propelled gun. And I wasn't sure whether to add it. There is a photo of it, but I can't show it, so I'll link you to where you can find it. But basically, it was armed with a 105mm howitzer. Now, I'm trying to read from the Japanese Wikipedia with Google Translate, which isn't all that good. But I think it was armed with the M37 105mm self-propelled howitzer. Other than that, I don't know the speed. I know it's got an enclosed, all-enclosed superstructure, but I don't know what the actual armour is. Now, one of the other reasons I wasn't sure whether to include it is because looking at the penetration characteristics for the howitzer, with a high explosive anti-tank shell, it can do 102mm of penetration. Now, if we go to the War Thunder game again, I can show you what this will allow it to deal with. So, I've put the Type 56 at Tier 5, so let's look at what Tier 5 tanks it could go against. Remember, 102mm penetration. It can take out the rear of the turret on the M103 or the sides and rear of the hull. It can take out the M46 Patton. It's a bit trollish. It's got 101mm of armour and the heat can penetrate 102, so don't know how that's going to work out. It can penetrate the M47 Patton too, so already it can beat all of the mediums and probably do quite well against the heavy tanks, the Americans. It can beat the M26. Can sort of do okay against the T-32 on the sides and rear of the hull. Let's go over to the Soviet Union. and look at their tier 5s. Could beat the ISU-152. IS-4 could just about take the rear of the hull, but it, you know, that's it. IS-3 could take the rear and sides of the hull. It could beat the T-54 1947 at the rears and side of the hull and the rear of the turret. Again, same for the T-54 1949 and the 1951. So it could take most of the Tier 5 Russians, and just for the sake of it, we'll look at the Germans. It could take the Koredian easy. The Jag Tiger, sides and rears again. The Panther 2, it can do the front just about, and the sides and rears of the turret and hull. The Mouse, no chance. And the Tiger 2, 105mm, the sides and rears again. So this would actually fit quite well. It could be the Panther 2, so it's, and the Panther 5. I think this would probably be about 6.6. So it can maybe face a mix of tier 5 and tier 4 and tier 5 tanks. You know, I wouldn't put it too high, because as we, I've already said, it can't take out the Mouse. It would struggle against the IS-4. I don't think it could even penetrate the IS-4. And I think the only other one it would have trouble with is the, if we can find it again, T-32. There's only like a few places it, you know, the sides and rear of the hull. But I think it would be quite a good little tank or self-propelled gun to add into the game. Now, moving on from the Type 56, we have a few other tank destroyers on the Japanese tank tech tree. The M1 tank destroyer, the M2 tank destroyer, and the Type 60, which the M1s are prototypes of. Now, according to my book, The World's Armoured Fighting Vehicles, which actually came out about the same time these were being put into production, 1962, the first one, the M1, was armed with 205mm recoilless guns, and the second one was armed with 206mm recoilless guns. Recoilless rifles, sorry. Now, the Type 60, which they were prototypes of, is armed with two M40 recoilless rifles. The Type 60 is also armed with a 50 caliber spotting rifle, so maybe we could use them for helping with spotting. Now, armour is actually very bad, 12mm. This is really not meant to get into any sort of fights, you know, dead on or straight on fights. Speed is 34 miles an hour, so it's, you know, it's meant to sort of shoot and scoot from the sounds of things. Now, I assume the penetration characteristics are going to be similar for all of these tank destroyers, which is about 400mm. In fact, I think this uses the same gun as the American M50 Ontos. Now, the recoilless rifles on the Type 60 are actually fixed into place, and it only has limited traverse, something like, if I can find it, 60 degrees traverse. But according to my book, the M2 actually had a mounting with 360 degree traverse. So this could be a very, very good little tank destroyer, or that particular prototype could. I would like all of these to be added in, if possible, to boost up Japan's Tier 5 numbers. That's potentially three tank destroyers if all of them are added in. I think they'd all be very useful. The only downside is that they're extremely vulnerable, very little armour, and they're in, you know, it's not an enclosed superstructure, and there's only three crew, so it's going to be very easy to be killed in these. The only other problem, really, is that they only carry six rounds of ammunition, assuming two are already loaded in the tank, or in the guns, so that puts it up to eight. Not sure how Gaijin will deal with that, maybe give it slightly faster reload at the cap points, but I suppose that's, you know, considering how powerful it is, that's, you know, it has to have some drawbacks, I suppose. But they'll have to be, well, they have to be Tier 5 on account of being post-war and being ridiculously overpowered gun-wise. I'd say battle rating of 7.7 or something, or 8 maybe. You know, it's going to have to be going against the best of the best, really, on account of that, of huge penetration power on the recoilless rifles. I think they'd be very good for the game, and I hope they're added. I really hope they're added in. They'd be such good little tanks, destroyers. So anyway, I hope you've enjoyed today's episode. Leave a like if you liked the episode, subscribe if you like these sorts of videos. Leave feedback, could always do with more feedback. Perhaps you disagree with the tiering of the tank destroyers, or you think there should be different battle ratings. You know, I'm always free to criticism of the tech trees. But anyway, thank you for watching, I'll see you next time.